The research that we conducted was in what's known as a Millennium Village. So these are these big, high-profile development projects that were started in 2005 in about 10 countries in sub-Saharan Africa. And they were controversial, they were expensive, and the idea was to make a lot of coordinated investment in one place at one time to get people out of poverty. So what we were interested in was getting away from the sort of question of whether or not it impacted people's lives in particular ways, and we wanted to know, okay, do people actually try to live within one of these villages, right? So they're area-based, which means that if you live within them, you get access to all of these project benefits and amenities. And so we looked at how land prices changed within the villages compared with outside of the villages before and after the village was established. And we found something kind of interesting, which is that we found that the land prices don't change in the village in response to the setting of the project. And what's interesting about that is that these projects involved enormous investment. And so we don't see them, that people are sort of clamoring to live within those areas in a way that's driving up the value of land. The interpretation of that is sort of threefold. So one possibility is that people are holding onto their land within those villages and not selling it because they're waiting for the sort of longer term benefits of the project. So with a longer timeline, we might find some effects. The second is that this is great, that, you know, poor people are not being crowded out, that, you know, that there's not this sort of inflationary pressure on land within the villages, even though there's all this investment. And the third possibility is that we just don't have enough data to establish any effect. But we think that the method has a lot of promise for other places in developing countries that have these kinds of area-based projects, and it can really provide some important insight along with traditional methods of evaluating effects.